assets, right? Your prayers are going to be for consolation as well. Let us pray. God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Margaret, who called to journey to you, and since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Live and reign with you to the Holy Spirit, God forever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. John saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. Also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will reside with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his son, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
In the face of me.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This all year filled all of children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren that I've gathered here today. And of course, we recognize the sadness of this moment. It's certainly so human to know that we have to say goodbye to a loved one. It costs us so much. Our hearts are not made to have to say goodbye. And of course, it's made all the more difficult during these days because of how long this time has been having to wait until finally we can gather together here after the storms to lay Margaret to rest. So we, of course, we begin just to recognizing the sadness that might touch each of you in its own way. But also, we're gathered together here in this church in hope. We're praying together in hope. And here in this Mass, of course, that hope is based upon something so beautiful and so powerful. I think a lot of times in the world today, there's a very easy hope that we might have for eternal life. It's, many people might think that, well, our human spirit, it's kind of like a balloon that's held by a child. And then when we die, it's released and we simply float away. But rather, as Christians, we have a much more beautiful, a much more foundational hope. And that is that Jesus Christ, as we heard in this gospel reading, has prepared a place for us and calls us to trust in him. And so the hope is not simply of any kind of ability for us to float away or any kind of reward that we might deserve from however good we may have been in this life, but rather the foundation of our hope is how good God is, how good and loving Jesus is, and that he embraces us, and that he calls us to life in him. And that's why we have this beautiful image always laid upon the casket now on the altar here of Christ crucified, to show us how much he loves us, how much he loves Margaret, desires to embrace her. That's why he has his arms wide open to show the depth of his love. And so indeed, that's the foundation of our hope today as we gather together and commend her to God's merciful arms. And again, we hear that call that he has, not only for her, but also I am the way, the truth, and the life. And so gathering together here to pray for her and to give thanks to God for her life, it's also an invitation for us to trust in that same Jesus, to trust in that same Lord who invites us to not let our hearts be troubled, but to have faith in him. And so with all these reasons, we gather together today, and in a way we're hearing about the wonderful way, the mysterious way, the hidden way in which God has been at work in her. From the very beginning of our Mass, we sprinkled the casket with holy water to remember her baptism, her entrance into the church. We close with the funeral pall to remember that baptismal garment and the white dignity of the Christian. And then we process through the church in the middle of all of you, here to the front of the altar. It's a little retelling of her entire life, how it began and she became one of Christ's flock in baptism, and how she journeyed through the middle of all of you, in the midst of all of you, now to this beautiful paschal candle representing Jesus himself into this altar, in a way that is a retelling of her life. And it's just like St. Paul said in that second reading about how exteriorly, there may be so many things that look like they're wasting away, that with difficulty, with faults, with failings, with old age, with infirmity, it may seem like the life you have is dwindling or fading away. But with faith in Christ, we know that there can be a hidden story of renewal, that maybe we only will be able to see from heaven itself. Jesus Christ working in our sister Margaret to, even as she failed in infirmity of old age and even to death, that what Jesus was working in here was true life-giving renewal to give her an eternal dwelling place. And so, with this in mind, we gather together today to offer our prayers for her and, of course, for one another. Let us thank God for the gift of the life of this woman. Let us pray for one another as we continue our time together and to lay her to rest and to commend her to God. Invite you all to please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ has risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join in prayers to his. And to each prayer we respond, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Margaret received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our sister Margaret was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many friends, members of our families have gone before us and await your kingdom. Grant to them too an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The family and friends of Margaret seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain, and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, give her peace and healer of souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated as I pray for the altar.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved us all like me. I once was lost,
not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior. May find in him a merciful judge. Lives and reigns forever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, to the end of our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not in vain. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing a hymn of your glorious without end. We mystery. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Margaret, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like this may also be one with him in his resurrection. And from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. For our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. When you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who fall to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let the perpetual light shine upon her. With with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. We arrive at the moment of Holy Communion, and I invite all practicing Catholics to prepare to receive Holy Communion this and forth. If you yourself are not Catholic or are not prepared to receive Holy Communion today, you may come forward if you wish, with your arms crossed over your shoulders, to receive a blessing.
Is dead.
in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Margaret may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Forgiving the final commendation, just a few words of instruction. We'll be going to the cemetery in Watsonville, Monroe Valley Cemetery. And so it's a bit of a drive. We will do our best to begin the ceremony there at 1 p.m. So please do your best to be ready at that time. And then also, because of all the rains and everything, there'll be a designated parking area, and then you'll have to walk a bit in order to get to the actual gravesite. So I want to make sure everybody was aware of that. And with faith in Jesus Christ, we must reverently bury the body of our sister. Let us pray with confidence to God, whose sight all creation lives, that he will raise up in holiness and power the mortal body of our sister and command her soul to be numbered among the blessed. May God grant her a merciful judgment, deliverance from death, and pardon of sin. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, carry her home to be at peace with the Father. May she rejoice forever in the presence of the eternal King and in the company of all the saints.
Thank you.